Sir, I've got to ask you about packing the courts. And I know that sure. you said yesterday you aren't going to answer the question until after the election. But this is the number one thing that I've been asked about from viewers in the past couple of days.
Well, you've been asked by the viewers who are probably Republicans who don't want me continuing to talk about what they're doing to the court right now.
Well, sir, don't the voters deserve to know?
No, they don't. I'm not going to play his game.
It's a simple question, and it's one, frankly, that Trump did not invent. It came from the progressives in the Democratic Party. And I thought it was odd when Vice President Biden said the other day, in response to a reporter's question, that voters do not deserve an answer on this. Of course voters deserve an answer on his position on every issue.
They'll know my opinion of court packing when the election's over. Now, look, I know it's a great question, y'all, and I don't blame you for asking. No, the moment I answer that question, the headline in every one of your papers will be about that. Other than focusing on what's happening now.
The composition of the Supreme Court is a matter of our constitutional structure as a nation, and it is a materially important question. What is the Biden campaign stance on the composition of the Supreme Court? Is Joe Biden satisfied with it?
Sure. Well, look, I think it's important to take a step back and to talk about the fact that a number of things have to happen before this is a conversation that is really relevant. It's a hypothetical. And what is not hypothetical is millions of people are already voting in this election. The majority of the American people, in fact, believe that the person that's elected on November 3rd, that is who should appoint the next Supreme Court justice.
Well, considering that you're working for the person who wants to be elected on November 3rd, this is not hypothetical for the guy who wants to be president. What is the campaign's perspective on the composition of the court? This should be an easy question.
Well, look, what I mean by that is it assumes that this fight we are in right now, it assumes that we lose that fight.
Now, you've refused to answer the question. Joe Biden has refused to answer the question. I think the American people would really like to know if Judge Amy Coney Barrett is confirmed to the Supreme Court of the United States. Are you and Joe Biden, if somehow you win this election, going to pack the Supreme Court to get your way?
I'm so glad we went through a little history lesson. Let's do that a little more. In 1864...
Well, I'd like you to answer the question.
No, yes. Mr. Vice President, I'm speaking. Okay. In 1864, one of the, I think, political heroes, certainly of the president, I assume of you also, Mr. Vice President, is Abraham Lincoln. Abraham Lincoln was up for re-election. And it was 27 days before the election, and a seat became open on the United States Supreme Court. Abraham Lincoln's party was in charge not only of the White House, but the Senate. But Honest Abe said, it's not the right thing to do. The American people deserve to make the decision about who will be the next president of the United States. And then that person can select who will serve for a lifetime on the highest court of our land. And so Joe and I are very clear. The American people are voting right now. And it should be their decision about who will serve on this most important body for a lifetime.
Thank you, Senator Harris.
People, Susan, are voting right now. They'd like to know if you and Joe Biden are going to pack the Supreme Court if you don't get your way in this nomination.
Let's talk about packing.
You gave a non-answer. Joe Biden gave a non-answer.
I'm trying to answer you
now. American people deserve a straight answer. And if you haven't figured it out yet, the straight answer is they are going to pack the Supreme Court if they somehow win this election.
You know, we have to come together. That's why I'm running. I'm running as a proud Democrat for the Senate.